Former Rubaga Deputy Resident City Commissioner Herbert Anderson Borora has been remanded to Luzira Prison until Friday, July 12th. Borora made an appearance today before Magistrate Ronald Kaizi at Buganda Road Magistrates Court to answer charges of hate speech and disseminating malicious information against the Speaker of Parliament, Anita Among.
That the charge sheet does not make reference to the particular tweet, the particular act, the particular thing for which the accused person is charged.
These allegations pertain to content posted on his social media account, X, formerly Twitter, between March and June 2024. His defense team, led by David Kamukama, also refuted the charges, accusing the prosecution of forwarding a defective charge sheet which does not provide clear and specific accusations against their client.
I would have brought in also, would have dissected the section in which the abuse person was charged, which requires sharing, reading or something like that.
Today, the prosecution, led by state attorneys Richard Birivumbuka, Joan Keko and Ivan Chazi, asserted that the charge sheet is neither flawed in content nor form. They claimed it contained sufficient details to enable the accused to comprehend the charges, which is why he entered a plea without hesitation. The judge adjourned the hearing to Friday, July 12, 2024, and Borora was sent to remand till then.
I adjourned the case till July 2024 at 9 o'clock for ruling on the guilt of the charge sheet. The person shall be kept on remand until then.
Six people have been arrested and detained at Kamuli Police Station for falsifying documents during the ongoing UPDF recruitment exercise. Lieutenant Ruben Difla, the spokesperson of the Fisheries Protection Unit, confirmed the incidents, adding that other 33 candidates were dropped for failing the medical tests. The recruitment commander for Busoga Sub-Region, Brigadier Chris Ogwal, said most of the candidates who failed medical tests had dental defects. Kamuli District RDC Rosemary Virunji has expressed disappointment over the candidates who have been dropped, saying this could lead to failure to raise the required number of 95 personnel allotted to the district. This recruitment exercise has left many disappointed after being dropped for failure to meet the requirements. The UPDF intends to recruit 9,627 youth aged 18 to 22 from all 135 districts of the country. The recruitment exercise is scheduled to end on July 14, 2024. Mbale Heroes Football Club leadership has reconciled with the Eastern Uganda Sports Association and the media fraternity after a nine-month media blackout. The vice chairman of Mbale Heroes FC, Mr. Badru Chemusto, acknowledged the importance of the media and the Eastern Uganda Sports Association, stating that it's time to apologize because the club needs everyone's support to remain in the Uganda Premier League, where it had just been promoted after 18 years. Eastern Uganda Sports Association President Joseph Mokoli has urged the media fraternity to resume engagement with Mbale Heroes FC activities, accepting the club's apology. Eastern Uganda Sports Association and the media fraternity in Eastern Uganda had ceased all engagement with Mbale Heroes FC following the mishandling of some journalists during the opening game with Kataka FC last year.